Hey everybody, it's John with Fresh Water Systems. Today we're going to talk about hard water. Hard water is water that has a level of calcium and magnesium mineral in the water. And what makes it hard is that those minerals don't like to be in solution. They want to come out of that solution and become hard minerals that are attached to things. And it becomes scale. It can also bond with soaps and detergents and create scum. So hard water is a problem. If you have it, you know you got it. Hard water is a result of the natural process or the hydrologic cycle of water evaporating from our oceans, turning into clouds, and then precipitating back to the earth. And the water that kind of percolates down through the soil and the rock into our underground aquifers, since water is such a great solvent, it's going to erode that rock on the way to the aquifer. And that rock in a great part of this country is very rich in calcium and magnesium. So that water molecule, when it gets into the aquifer and then up through the ground to our water supplies, whether it be a well, or maybe into a surface water supply that's fed from an underground supply, we have hard water that's loaded with these minerals. Calcium and magnesium specifically are troublesome because they don't like to be in solution. They want to be back into a hard or a precipitate form. And they create scale because it bonds with the surfaces of the things it comes in contact with. You'd notice it most on your shower heads or on the pot when you boil water to cook eggs, for example. That white scum that appears in that pot after you've boiled the water, those are hardness minerals that have come out of solution. Hard water is found predominantly in groundwater supplies. A lot of municipalities use groundwater supplies for their water. Most well owners, that's where their water comes from, is the ground. Surface water supplies like Lake Erie, Lake Michigan, or large lakes that are mostly fed by precipitation and rain, they're not going to have that heavy mineral content. Testing for hard water is relatively simple. You can either get a test strip that you dunk in the water and then compare the color of the strip to the bottle it comes in. Or you can do a chemical test, which is a little bit more accurate. We sell them here at Freshwater Systems. And that will give you precisely how many grains per gallon of hardness you may have in your water supply. Beyond the nuisance aspect of hard water, there's a real cost to hard water, and it lines up basically with having to clean the effects of hard water off of shower doors, off of your dishwasher, on your appliances, your glassware, and there's also the cost of the wear and tear on your water using appliances, specifically the hot water heater or the dishwasher. Both of those appliances are heating water to do their job. The water heater, obviously, that's its job, is to heat water. And as water heats up, the molecular activity speeds up, and that calcium and magnesium come out of solution that much faster. And on an electric water heater, that scale adheres to the heating elements. The efficiency of that water heater goes way down because now it has to heat through the scale that's accumulating on those heating elements. A gas-fired heater, same thing, except now the scale is dropping to the bottom of the water heater. We're literally having to heat the rock first before it can heat the water. In a study done by the Patel Institute, they found out that a heater on soft water will last the entire 15-year expected lifespan without loss of any efficiency. And the dishwasher, same result. The other thing they watched for was shower heads, because that's probably the most visual example of the effect of hard water you see. As the water blows through the nozzle of that that shower head, those hardness minerals are coming out of solution very fast. And if your shower head looks white and filmy, that means that your hardness is scaling the shower head up, and it won't be long before it starts clogging some of those spray nozzles, and then you got a really inefficient shower head. Soft water, you have a wonderful spray through the shower head without that scale appearing. So a huge problem with hard water. What's the cost? Studies show that 20% of every dollar you spend at the grocery store, if you live on hard water conditions, you're spending on cleaning supplies to battle the effects of hard water. 20%. And you think about it, if you spend $100 or a couple hundred bucks a week on groceries, $20 to $40 of that money is being spent on cleaning supplies. Can you imagine putting that money back in your pocket with soft water? Another benefit that you'll see with soft water is to your skin and your hair. When you're dealing with hard water, those hard water minerals actually get into your pores and they get into your hair. So you're having to use moisturizers, you're having to use conditioners for your hair. With soft water, you can eliminate the majority of that. The other thing that you run into is your laundry. That hard mineral gets into the fabric of your clothing and it turns the colors dingy. And it also makes them hard. I mean, there's actually a stiffness to the fabric because of hard water. With soft water, your colors stay vibrant, your clothes last longer, and towels, for example, are a pleasure to use, not something that's going to feel like sandpaper. We get questions sometimes on, is hard water bad for you? Well, it's not necessarily a health concern to drink hard water, although there are some that think that the heightened level of minerals is not good for you because humans don't get their minerals from water. We get our minerals rather from plants or fruits and vegetables. Water is good for lubrication, for our organs. It's good for hydration, for our joints. But it's not necessarily good to have lots of minerals in that. So your kidney has to deal with it. And I've always made the comment, should you get a filter or do you want to be the filter? Something to think about with heavy mineralized water. So you have hard water. What's the best way to get rid of it? What's the best way to get soft water so that we can save money? And that is a traditional ion exchange water softener. That's meaning that we're going to run water through that, and it's the softener has resin inside that's going to grab a hold of those hardness causing minerals, and it's going to release a little bit of sodium in the process. Now, there's a lot of people that don't like softeners because of the sodium, but truly it's the best way to deal with hardness because we're actually taking the hardness minerals out of the water. That little bit of sodium we can deal with a reverse osmosis system, or take a look at our chart. It's not as much sodium added as you might think. Now, if you still want to get the added sodium out of your water from a water softener, the best answer to that is reverse osmosis for point of use. The reverse osmosis system will take care of the water you're actually going to consume, make ice, or cook with, and that's going to reduce the sodium from the water, even the naturally occurring sodium. If you are coming from a well, chances are you've already got some sodium in your water. So the reverse osmosis system will virtually get 99% of that sodium out. So if you got high blood pressure, doctor says no on the sodium, the reverse osmosis system is the best answer for that. An alternate to ion exchange water softening is going to come under the category of scale inhibitors. There's no such thing as a salt-free water softener. Again, that goes back to the efficiency of ion exchange, taking the mineral out. Everything else is a scale inhibitor. And what they're built to do is hold the hardness minerals in solution so that they don't come out and create scale. You won't see the same benefits of soft water with a scale inhibitor that you do with an ion exchange water softener. Scale inhibitors work. They work as long as you're not on a well water supply. Guess where you find most of your hardness? And what they do is they create little crystals around the hardness minerals. If there's any kind of iron or manganese in the water, it pretty much makes that media inert. It won't do anything at that point. Well, that's all I've got for hard water. Be sure and like this video, subscribe to our channel, and check out our water softening products and anti-scale products on freshwatersystems.com.